here we are on a lovely warm afternoon in South Northumberland near the village of Elswick. Not the place where the witches are. However, I do have Andrea Banner with me.
Hello.
Tell me about what got you into running and when.
Okay. So, I was a bit of a couch potato. Didn't take part in sport at school or uni. And then moved up to Newcastle to move in with my now husband, Mike Russell.
And when was that?
That was 1994.
Okay, a couple of years ago then.
Realised that the Great North Run was a huge thing in the Northeast. I would see lots of people out running. And Mike described these fantastic runners where he worked at the DSS in Benton who go out running at lunchtime, which sounded a very peculiar pastime to me. But he was running after work, so I decided to join him. So I dusted off some trainers and would go out and annoy him by tagging on behind him until I got to the point where I started to do the odd 5 mile race. My first one at Amble with the Amble Dolphin Run, it was called. And then that same year, I think it would have been September 95, somebody dropped out of Great North Run. So I took the number and ran it. And Mike didn't expect me to finish, but I did it in 2 hours. I felt quite comfortable.
You must have been pleased with that.
Really pleased. I wasn't so pleased at the end when I couldn't find Mike, because he thought it'd take me 2 hours 45. So he didn't turn up at our arranged meeting point. So I was shivery cold by the time he found me, but I was delighted. And that was the start. So then I started running more regularly as an unattached runner in the Northeast. I did lots of the club organised races, 10Ks mainly, until eventually I did a 10 mile race in Stanley, came second, and somebody tapped me on the shoulder and asked me why I wasn't in a club.
And who was that?
I do not know who the gentleman was, but I did give him my number. And sure enough, 2 days later, a lady called me, and it was Kim Matthews, Elswick Harriers, invited me along to come try a night session at Elswick. So I went along, I was cursing, I was going straight from work. The traffic was horrendous on the quayside, because Pavarotti was singing at the arena, and I started to regret then agreeing to go along to Newburn when I could have just gone home and run around Jasmine. Anyway, I went, and I went into the senior group with Kim and discovered that they were doing a 5 mile warm-up run to Bladen and back, followed by circuit training in the hall. That's what we did in those days on a Tuesday night.
What does running do for you? How does it make you feel? Why do you keep doing it?
All right, well, I just, in the early days, found it got easier and easier. The more hours, the more miles that you put in. It was just that release after a day at work. It was so easy just to be able to go in, have a sip of water, put on your trainers and go out whenever it was convenient. So I love that. I love the races and the atmosphere, and I like the competition. I like chasing this petite lady who everyone cheered, and I was always up alongside her, a lady called Yvonne Swinhoe, who was also Elswick. So I used to chase her as an unattached. So it was nice to be able to join her in the team. And then I got into marathon running before I joined Elswick. Just like endurance running, I'm a bit lazy, I don't like to push myself. I don't like going fast. So I like the marathon pace. Just running within your capacity and the opportunity to do long, leisurely weekend runs.
That's quite funny, really, because I don't see you as a leisurely or lazy runner. Some of the times that you do are really good. How does music fit into that? What's your favourite song? And how does it fit into your running?
Okay. Well, I've picked... Sisters are doing it for themselves. Aretha Franklin. And they paired with... She paired with Eurythmics to perform this. And what makes me smile is that when I did the Liverpool Women's only 10K race, would have been about year 2000. Around my home city, I'm from Liverpool, a chap had come out, put up a little trestle table outside his house with a ghetto blaster. Uh-huh. Anyone remembers what they are? And he was blazing out this song, and it just brought a smile to my face and just reminded me of, yeah, how good it makes you feel to be a woman and to be running. Albeit that was an all-women field, but I do like competing against the men as well. And it's also on the same course as the Liverpool Half, where I got my very best half marathon time.
What time was that?
1:27. Excellent. Don't ask me in seconds. So long ago.
A 1:27 is a really good time in anyone's book. Certainly in mine. Not one I've bettered yet, but maybe. Excellent. So let's hear your song. Now there was a time when we used to say, left behind every great man, there had to be a great woman. But all in these times have changed. You know that it's no longer true. So we're coming out of the kitchen, cause there's something we forgot. Thank you, Andrea. She's the ladies' run captain of Elswick Harriers. And thank you for your desert island trek.
Thanks, Simon.
So I'm running off into the sunset. This is where the musical fading happens.